In the blue corner, the challenger. He is the super bantamweight champion of the world. He fights out of Santurce, Puerto Rico. He weighs 126 pounds. He is undefeated in his professional career. Introducing Wilfredo Gomez. And in the red corner, the WBC featherweight champion of the world. He fights out of Santiago Tiancastango, Mexico. He weighs 126 pounds. Here is the very popular Salvador Sanchez. 15 rounds of boxing.
Okay. The third man in the ring will be Carlos Padilla, who has called many a championship fight here.
Seconds.
We listen to what he has to say.
10 seconds.
Yes, mate.
10 seconds. Who is the 10 seconds? Manager. Principal.
A bit of confusion over who the chief seconds are for Carlos Padilla. He wants to know exactly who the official and top man in each corner is.
Who is the chief seconds? Chief seconds. Yeah. Call the chief seconds. Chief seconds.
He wants to know exactly who is in charge in that corner in case for any reason they were going to stop it. Although the corner really can't stop a championship fight, can it?
The corner cannot stop a championship fight unless they have changed the rules for this one.
They're definitely not changing the rules, Larry. That's for sure.
Well, he's asking for the chief seconds. I don't know why.
He wants to know who's in control of the corners for sure in case he may want
to
take something off the face or whatever.
Let's get... Avoid using any kind of
force. Well, maybe again, they might have a little bit too many people in the corner and they want to be able to control the corner. So he want to find out who's the chief second so he can get the people don't belong in the corner out of there.
Carlos Padilla is showing that he's going to be the boss of this one because the spirits are extremely high. The WBC World Featherweight Championship, the Battle of the Little Giants, is just about to begin. You're looking at Salvador Sanchez. He'll be taking on Wilfredo Gomez. Here we go. Round one.
That is exciting.
Sanchez in the blue trunks and Gomez in the red, white, and blue.
One thing I like to say, a lot of people don't think Gomez can do any boxing, but I see Gomez boxing. This is what he's coming out doing now. So he can box in the punch, and it's going to be a very interesting fight.
That's right. He's a very, very clever boxer, too, besides the fact that he can really punch.
Again, we repeat the record of Wilfredo Gomez. 32 professional fights, 32 knockouts. Very first one, he did have a draw, 32-0-1 is his actual record. 32 knockouts.
What makes this fight so interesting is both of these fighters have been there. They both is a champion for a number of fights, and they both represented their country. This is what makes this fight so interesting.
Another factor we point out, don't forget that Gomez is a former world super bantamweight champion. He gave up that title because of making the weight to move up to this weight classification.
That's right, so we have two world champions.
Sanchez with a right hand.
Oh, Gomez is down, put down. It's up to 4 and 5. He's back on his feet, as you see. A surprise left hook, I guess.
That's right.
I didn't see the punch. It must be a quick punch. I thought he slipped. But Sanchez was hurt, and then he turned around and hit Gomez.
That's the
Gomez is in trouble.
Gomez is in trouble. Gomez got the fight.
Gomez in big trouble.
They're in big trouble.
He's holding
ready
him.
To go.
He got the hold. Gomez is getting hit with punches. I think the fight's Well, it ain't easy.
Oh, he fell.
Gomez is hurt. So, this fight is not going to go. Gomez is going to get hurt. But he's still fighting. That shows you're a champion.
Well, this is something we didn't expect to see this early.
Gomez seems sluggish, and he hurt very, very bad. His legs are gone. He can't move. He has no balance in his legs. And right now, Sanchez just teeing off on Gomez.
He's holding on.
But Gomez still got that big savage. He's holding on. And right now, trying to get his head clear. So if he can hold on this round, he might be able to survive it. But I don't see no way that Gomez can survive this.
He survived the round.
It's a miracle, Larry, that he got through that round. A miracle to get through the round.
It's a miracle to get through the round. It'll be a miracle for Gomez to come back this round. We got to see how much that round took out of Gomez. Again, his corner is working very hard on it, but I don't see any chance for Gomez. But Sanchez is ready, he's confident, and he's going to go out there and try to take him out.
Carlos Palomino, I know you're shocked by that first round.
I am. I didn't expect Sanchez to have that kind of power, but he hurt him with a left hook right there. I think it was the beginning of it, and then came back with that one and hurt him bad.
It was actually the right hand that caught him first, was, and then a little left.
Yeah, it was the uppercut.
Again, that left looked like it didn't hurt him.
It's kind of an uppercut left hook, and really surprising. And Gomez is definitely hurt. He's still hurt. He's still very
shaky. And tied his guy up.
Sanchez is absolutely fresh, and Gomez is still kind of staggering and glassy-eyed.
Sanchez is very cool, too.
Gomez is trying to put all the power into the punches now, but he's making a mistake by trading punches with Sanchez because he's not familiar yet.
That's right. That's a very good point, Larry.
Reaching way back to his experience, to everything he has to try and hang in here.
That's right. He might be coming out of it. He got his bounce back. It looks pretty good on his leg. But again, he's not clear yet. You can see it in his eyes. Sanchez looks very good. He looks confident. It looks like he's trying to take a shot, but Gomez can punch. Gomez taking good punches to the body, but Sanchez is throwing three or four punches at a time. Makes it kind of hard for Gomez to get in there. Gomez looks a little slow, but he's very confident.
Gomez's eyes are starting to get a little bit clear. They were real glassy before this point. It's starting to come back a bit.
Yes, it is. And Sanchez not really doing anything. He's just bouncing on the stove. Which if I was Sanchez, I'd have kept using the jab, try to set him up for the right hand. He let Gomez get off again. Sanchez lay on the rope and let a puncher like Gomez get in there.
Just got hit.
A real good right hand gets through that time. Gomez is in big trouble again, Larry.
Yes, he hit again. He hurt again. But again, when Sanchez takes a punch, he did not change his pressure. Shows a lot of confidence.
Carlos Gomez still has a rubbery leg, though.
Yes, he is. And like Larry says, he's taking a very big chance. Trying to come in and try punches, but it's not clear yet.
No good round that time for Gomez, but considering that he got hurt, the first round. I think he came back very good. What do you think about it?
Well, I think he made he did a lot to come back, and he's trying, and I think he's making a mistake by trying to get inside and trade punches with Savoca. It's not clear-headed, but he did well. He got in there and he tried to come back. He said that was a close round. I would call it an even round. Here we are.
Is Gomez again putting the pressure on? I think he gets tagged in the middle of this flurry again. Oh, Gomez gets through with a good left.
There's the right hand that kind of shook him up again.
Van just takes good punches, and he does not change the expression every time, anytime he get hit.
Well, a surprisingly fast start to something we didn't expect here. But coming up to round number three, Salvador Sanchez had Wilfredo Gomez on the canvas in round one. Surprising us all, and it took all the courage and guts that Gomez had to get through round one, and we're up to round three now.
What I think Gomez should do is fight Sanchez, not try to box him. Sanchez is a much better boxer than Gomez.
Right.
We've seen that's what got him in trouble the first round, trying to box him. So Gomez should stay there and try to get inside, put the pressure on him, and wear him down inside.
Fast-paced fight from 15. Now you wonder how they're going to keep it up.
And we know that Sanchez can go 15 rounds, but Gomez hasn't went 15 rounds in so long, so that might be the factor in the fight also.
Like Sanchez, that no matter what happens, no change in expression.
No change. You just don't even bother. It seems like he's taking punch. It's just a still face. No bother at all. He's a very good boxer. He's moving, he's circling well. And that's what he got to do for 15 rounds. And I think they keep it tight. Good punch by Sanchez again. Again that time. I would say get inside of Sanchez's jab and work the midsection to try to come up with combination. But again, Sanchez couldn't fight him inside his jab. Gomez was off balance that time. It wasn't really a punch.
Every time Gomez is trying to pressure Sanchez like that, he's got himself in trouble though.
Yes.
Gomez just got warned for using an elbow inside.
For Gomez, wait for Gomez to punch, and then he counters. So Gomez got to be very careful. Man, a good left hook, another good left from Fernando Sanchez. I don't think Sanchez would want to get in there and play punch with Gomez. He should circle out and get out of there. Give Gomez a chance to find him and play punch with him.
Carlos, the pace has been unbelievable.
That's right. I can't believe this. This goes 15 this way. It's going to be unbelievable. It's tremendous condition of both athletes.
Wilfredo continues to come on. He won't stay back and catch any breather at all. He keeps coming on.
I think Gomez is settled down. He's starting to man punch. Settle down a little more, and he'll start firing his mark with that right hand after the jab. He's shooting the right hand over the head.
I have to ask you two fellas again to help me score that round. It was kind of, the signs with Sanchez looked good, but Gomez got his share of punches in there and was very aggressive in that round.
I call it an even round myself.
That's right.
Because both fighters were scoring punches. Sanchez was countering, and Gomez was then working inside. I see a very, very close round, and I wouldn't want to call that round.
I was showing you that shot that Larry talked about where Gomez looked like he was going down, but it was more of a slip. He was kind of moving towards his left and just kind of slipped as he was backing away.
It was more of a slip. He was off balance.
Here it is at a different angle now. Same series. Featherweight champion. championship. Sanchez, the champion in blue. Gomez, the challenger. Former world super bantamweight champ in red, white, and blue.
Gomez has a really nasty welt coming up under his right eye.
I still don't see how Gomez survived it and still come back to fight like he's doing now. Shows you a lot of ability, a lot of determination.
Folks watching at home can see that welt coming up that Carlos Palomino was talking about on the right eye of Wilfredo Gomez.
So far, the eye is not in a bad spot because it's underneath the eye. And as long as it's underneath the eye, the ref will let it go. Gomez is starting to wait. I see he's trying to counter over Sanchez getting jabbed, but Sanchez got a fast jab, and you cannot wait for the counter. You just got to keep going and do your own thing.
Pace has slowed down just a bit this round.
Good punch by Sanchez.
Perfect right hand, man.
Sanchez is a very good boxer, and he can keep his hands down. He can stay out of the way from the big punches. He's doing a good job of moving out and staying out of the way of Gomez's power.
Saron Sanchez, one of the best. He's got a terrific guy. He's a terrific boxer. He knows what's happening at all times.
Well, I got to lean a little bit towards the boxer because myself, I'm a boxer. And Sanchez is doing a good job of boxing. And Gomez is more of the Joe Frazier type coming in, throwing punches. And it's just, if Sanchez can keep his movement, his boxing ability going, I think he might be able to pull this fight out.
Again, we're in round four. Wilfredo Gomez was down in the first round and barely survived it and has come back since then.
Good right hand by Gomez. Good right hand by Sanchez. Left hand by Sanchez. These guys are trading punches. Gomez is trying to tee out on him. I don't like him if Sanchez in that corner like that. Because I know that Gomez got a power punch, and he hits good. Again, Sanchez hits good. But maybe he knows something I don't know, Bobby.
Every time he's getting that corner, Sanchez has come out the winner. That's the bell. Ending round number four.
Some looks at each other there. A couple of punches after the bell, and Gomez was doing some tremendous scoring underneath there in that corner. I saw him throwing some very good body punches.
And we go to the corner of Gomez once again. You can see them putting the ice and working on that eye. And he still looks tremendously exhausted to me.
Yes, his punches still affect him a little bit. But he's fighting. You know, that's just again a sign of a true champion to come out after the first round of knockdown and do all of this.
Larry, that's not actually ice. Here's the flurry right after the bell.
That round, I give that round myself to Gomez because Sanchez was standing in the corner and for a few seconds, Gomez was throwing a lot of punches and Sanchez didn't do anything back. So I think Gomez won that round, Bobby.
On the aggressiveness, right, yeah. We'll all give it to Gomez, I think. Here we go, round number five.
The eye is almost completely shut now.
That's where he powers, see? He's powerful on that fly. He got him on the rope. Sanchez don't have no room to move back when it's slip punches on the rope. He should be boxing on that. They traded punches again there. That's where Sanchez won, right in the middle of the ring. Not on the rope.
Right eye of Wilfredo Gomez is completely shut now. I don't know if he has any vision out of it at all.
Yes, he still can see out of that. But again, Sanchez is backing up on the ropes again. Should never be on the ropes. I don't like being on the ropes.
That's right. You know, it seems like he's very effective. He's in the middle of the round of the ring, and then he seems to want to go to the ropes. That's where Gomez is much stronger.
Gomez gets good shots in on Sanchez, but to land on that rope. That time I see Sanchez change the expression. I don't know if that meant anything or not.
It looked like he got hit a little bit low that time, but.
After all, Bobby, I think we've got a good fight here. It turned out to be a very, very interesting fight after that first round knockout. Sanchez over to Gomez's jab.
Gomez almost appears to have got his second win.
Yes, he did. He's right there in front of him. He's keeping on the rope. Nothing left for him to hit Sanchez with. Sanchez shouldn't take those punches. He shouldn't be on the rope.
Now you can see clearly that Gomez has plenty of vision with that right eye.
That's right. And he hit Sanchez inside. That rope. I can hear the punches. I can feel them when Gomez land on Sanchez. Gomez is in trouble here.
That's right, Gomez was hurt that round. Again, looked like he was ready to go and the bell sounded. His eye is in bad shape, too.
All right, we'll show you some more of that action from the corner now. When Sanchez really came on the rebound.
Yes, that one punch that he hit Gomez with, the one that hurt him, all the rest of them didn't land, really. Just that one shot.
And another angle, as Sanchez getting tagged a few times.
Yeah, but Sanchez is getting tagged, but he's not showing hurt. Gomez is showing hurt. That's not a good sign.
So the left eye is showing some damages now as he's taking some bruising punches.
I don't see this fight going but a couple more rounds. If Sanchez come out and start boxing, putting combinations together, I feel that he will stop Gomez. But Gomez again showed you all his determination the second round, the first round, and the last round that he's able to stay, he got stamp on.
The sign of a true champion is one who can get off the canvas and come back and win a fight. And that's going to take all the courage in the world for Wilfredo Gomez. And he's certainly shown us one thing, he has the heart of a champion no matter what happens to him.
That's right. Sanchez got hit with punches like that there. Right there, and he shows a little sign. Maybe Gomez is starting to hurt a little bit now. But we know that every time Sanchez lands a punch on Gomez, he's hurting him because Gomez is kind of under the eye. Both eyes are starting to puff up, and Gomez, to me, seems like he's in trouble. Sanchez is starting to box out of it now, but he got hit with a left hook while he was coming out of that corner. Thank you. little bit taller than Gomez, but Gomez on his reading, on his measurements, have a little bit longer arm than Sanchez. Here they go, trading punches again. Boy, it's a tough fight, boy, I tell you.
It's a war, there's no doubt about it.
No doubt about it, and you gotta give Gomez a lot of credit, man. He's got a lot of courage, because he's taking some shots, and that eye is in bad shape. He keeps coming.
Gomez has taken a lot of shots. He showed you that he's a man, he's a champion, and he's willing to give up his title to come up in a weight class and show the people around the world that he's a champion. So he has nothing to shame here, because he's doing a heck of a job, and I don't count Gomez out yet, because he's still got a lot going for himself. Good right hand there again by Gomez. Sanchez is starting to miss.
It seems like the rounds are faster than 3 minutes to us because there's so much action in them.
That's right.
I'm excited, Bob. I'm glad I'm here to be able to watch it as close as I'm watching it, and to be able to call it around the world, and to let the people know throughout the world that we're watching two great gladiators in Sanchez and Gomez, and it's a shame that one of these fighters have to lose.
That's right. These two guys are tremendous athletes, and I see there's a, you know, Gomez is going to have a lot of problems because he's, both eyes are beginning to really close now. He's going to have problems seeing out of both these eyes.
Well, you can see what's going on in the corner there. It's just a question of in between every round. Look at the face of Gomez. He's really, really taking a lot of punishment to the face.
Yes, I've never seen Gomez puffed up like this in any day of the boxing.
Sanchez is very cool, he's very calm and collected, and doesn't seem to get rattled, you know.
Sanchez is starting to box a little bit more this time. He's out on his toes, he's circling. Even Gomez is doing the same thing to try to draw him in. Now he's backing up. I think it's not good for Gomez to back up though. Punches by Sanchez that time.
Sanchez worked downstairs for the first time and taking a little bit of that wind out of Gomez.
That's the first time Gomez has been on the ropes like this since the first round.
Gomez's legs are still rubbery.
Very wobbly, very rubbery.
Even when Sanchez throw a punch, he don't make us, he don't even change. I mean, Sanchez throw a punch, he don't even change the expression. And when he takes one, he don't change the expression. Yeah. Sanchez get on the ropes, he's vulnerable for those punches, and Gomez wants him up there. Good punches by Gomez that time. Double the right hand up on the ropes.
That's right. He's the aggressor, still, he's changed now.
Sanchez got hit with another right hand, see? He's going on ropes, and that's where he's going to take a toll around. He's going to take a toll that way.
Gomez's legs really shook that time.
Gomez's legs are almost quivering.
That's right.
Gomez is really a determined fighter. He keep pressing the action all the way. Keep pressing the action. He's taking punches from Sanchez and throwing his own punches. In his punch. Maybe he did that for a reason to land a big one, but he slowed down that round in his punch.
It's the end of round number 7. Another strong round for Sanchez.
puts a lot of good fights together.
This is Tahiti.
He couldn't put a better fight together than Sanchez and Gomez.
Wow.
We're talking about Wilfredo Gomez is kind of expecting a new addition to his family. He was hoping to have the title.
Yes, this will be a great surprise for his new son or daughter, whatever. Gomez can win this title, and I'm sure when the son grows up or daughter grows up, they will really have something to talk about.
Now, that would be some...
Watch this exchange now.
Here we are. Some great punching going on.
See that crisp right hand, though. Gomez scored a couple of punches, but with Sanchez, it really had the power behind it.
That's right. Whenever Sanchez lands, Gomez usually takes a step backwards, and he feels it.
Well, as you look at both corners, you can see just in the facial expression of the two of them which man is out in front of the fight. But again, we can't say enough for Wilfredo Gomez for his staying power and the courage that he's had throughout this fight.
He's very rubbery legged. He's very shaky.
Okay.
Round number eight.
Sanchez is on target. Gomez looks like he's been through a war. He's still fighting hard. He's still fighting hard. I feel that Gomez wants to try to go for broke because he knows his eyes are swollen up on him and he wants Sanchez in the corner so he can shoot all he got. Gomez is trying to counter over the jab of Sanchez, and it's something to see because Gomez's eyes are closed and he's trying to counter a right hand over the jab.
That's right. He's really has to concentrate right now to see because his eyes are two little slits. But he's trying. I know that he wants to get the big one in so he can get Sanchez out of there.
Gomez got hit with a right on the counter that time.
Three good shots to the body by Sanchez.
Three straight left hooks to the body by Sanchez.
Three good left hooks to the body, and Gomez didn't try to do anything about it. So
right.
Sanchez shows you again, he got confidence. It is a very, very good fight, tough fight tonight here at Caesars Palace.
The pace that you folks are seeing right now, it's been like this from the opening bell.
That's right, I tell you, the fans are getting their money's worth for this one.
Again, they're taking plenty of pressure. Gomez is on the rope, he's cut under the nose again. He's hurt. Gomez is hurt.
It's down.
Pass up to three. It's four. I don't know if Gomez can make it.
Gomez won't get up. He's hurt.
I don't think he can make it.
He won't make it.
Five. He's up.
He can't see. The ref is down.
That's it.
It's
over.
The fight. Referee Carlos Padilla stops the fight in the eighth round. A TKO win in the eighth round for Salvador Sanchez, who retains the WBC World Featherweight Championship.
So.
Hello, Sam. CF, do you know anyone in this corner?
As you can see, it's pandemonium in the ring. Carlos Palomino is going to attempt to interview the champion. Get him spun around. Get him spun around and spin yourself around. All right,
Referee Carlos Padilla stops the contest at 2:09 of the eighth round. The winner and still featherweight champion of the world, Salvador Sanchez.
Siempre se ha demostrado que se habla mejor con los puños que con la boca.
Efectivamente, yo por eso me reservé.
En el primer episodio estuviste a punto de ganar por nocaut. Se escapó milagrosamente, pero fue peor para él porque ha recibido más golpes que en toda su carrera profesional.
En el boxeo gana quien pega, no quien habla.
Te felicito, Salvador, y el boxeo mexicano se enorgullece de tener en ti un gran campeón.
Bueno, señores,
también.
Enhorabuena, campeón.
We have with us Jose Suleiman, the president of the World Boxing Association, is with us. Carlos Palomino is here.
Lo felicito. Es usted un gran campeón de lo mejor que ha tenido México en su historia. Estoy orgulloso de usted, Salvador. De veras. Además, un ejemplo y que siga usted dando ese ejemplo al mundo y a los jóvenes. Con otro gran a quien yo admiro, Carlos Palomino.
Felicitaciones, Salvador. Una tremenda pelea mía. Quiero preguntar, hacerte una pregunta. Se hablaba mucho tanto del poder de Gómez. ¿Sentiste los golpes de él en cual momento?
Efectivamente, no me llegó a lastimar con ningún golpe, pero se siente inmediatamente la pesadez de sus puños.
¿Te sorprendió a ti que pudiste lastimarlo en el primer round?
No me sorprendió, porque yo me preparé para luchar desde el primer round, como lo demostré.
Muchas gracias y felicitaciones otra vez, que dures muchísimo.
Okay, we'll spin around over here. We'll get Larry in here.
Bring him around this way.
Larry, we'll get in here together. We'll turn around up here to this. That camera up there. Okay,